An alternative way to assemble and manage mobile networks is emerging, driven by Open RAN developments. And key to any Open RAN-based deployment is the software that enables automated management of the network. Now, to address that requirement, Ericsson has announced the launch of a new software product. And to find out more, I'm talking with Patrik Birgersson, Product Manager within Solution Area OSS at Ericsson, and his colleague, David Espadas, who is Global Product Marketing Lead for OSS. So welcome, gentlemen. Thanks for joining us today. Patrik, can you tell us what exactly Ericsson is releasing today?
Ericsson is releasing its Intelligent Automation Platform. It's a new OSS offering supporting the deployment of standalone applications, so-called R-apps. It utilizes the R1 interface as being specified in O-RAN to separate the applications from the platform and to expose the platform capabilities to the applications. It also entails a lot of the automation enablers that you would expect from a platform like this, including AIML policy handling and so on and so forth. And it supports the data access and the network control functions and introduces support for the O-RAN management interfaces. And we are also introducing three different R-apps for automation of RAN deployments and optimization applications.
And David, what are the drivers behind this launch?
Well, Ericsson has been here for more than 140 years. We've been through all kinds of evolutions and revolutions. And we have this very long-term commitment to our customers very much to our heart. So we are very much used to keep our ear to the ground. And what we are getting from our customers is that they are exploring things like virtualization, cloud nativeness, openness, and disaggregation of their technology stacks with the overall ambition of automating operations. So we want to support them in that journey through automation, while ensuring they are able to secure always the best performance from their network. So when we started creating this product and all the related offering, we had four main pillars that drive this strategy. And we think these actually tick all boxes of these customer expectations and customer ambitions in this area. It's an open platform with open interfaces and a companion SDK that will act as a catalyzer for innovation in our customer's journey towards automation. Second, this is a multi-technology. We know that for the majority of our customers, networks are much bigger than what Open RAN will cover now and will cover in the next few years. And with that in mind, our platform supports the wider radio access network technology spectrum with Open RAN and purpose-built RAN included. Third, this is multi-vendor, because we know very well that our customers typically run multi-vendor networks, managing different generations of the mobile technology. And we are pretty much used to that interworking with other companies, mostly driven by standardization. So we are focusing from that point of view very early on in providing support for other radio equipment providers in our platform. And the fourth pillar of our platform is being cloud native, so that we can ensure the required scalability and operational efficiency. And beyond these pillars, the most important input for our strategy is always the interaction with our customers. We have continuous conversations with communication service providers globally around these aspects. And the feedback we are getting is extremely positive, indicating that these drivers align very well with their strategic direction.
And David, how is the Ericsson Intelligent Automation Platform different from a pure implementation of the Service Management and Orchestration, or SMO, as defined by the O-RAN Alliance?
First, we are taking the O-RAN specification for this function, for Service Management and Orchestration, that we call SMO, and implementing those and even more. We are taking it one step forward with support for purpose-built RAN as well, so that the operator can reap the benefits of RAN automation and the R-apps from all their network from day one. And second, we realize as well that any platform is only as valuable as the benefits it enables to capture. So we are launching our R-app roadmap together with the platform and a number of R-apps already at the same time we are making this launch.
And Patrik, in what way will the Ericsson Intelligent Automation Platform be multi-vendor?
It is multi-vendor from three aspects. Firstly, when it comes to the applications that can be deployed on the platform, we will support applications developed by ourselves, of course, but also applications developed by our customers and by third-party application vendors as well. Secondly, when it comes to the integration towards surrounding OSS products, we are supporting integration there over standardized interfaces towards OSS and DSS products, such as resource orchestration or service assurance. And we are utilizing then the emerging open standards, of course, but also relying on things like ETSI and TMF and 3GPP. Last, it's a mediation of on the southbound side towards the RAN networks. There we support mediation of also third-party RAN networks over the ORAN interfaces. And for radio access networks that does not implement those interfaces, we support integration via the EMS systems, then, for instance, utilizing agreements between vendors in the OSSII framework.
And how will this new automation platform fit into Ericsson's current software portfolio?
Ericsson's Intelligent Automation Platform is a new OSS offering, complementing existing products in the OSS suite. And it is targeted towards both purpose-built RAN and cloud RAN. And it's aiming for 5G and 4G as well. Building automation cases for that. It will eventually extend into other domains as well, for instance, supporting use cases where you have RAN transport automation in the front hall space or mid hall for deployment of features, workload placements, and things like that. And it is, developed in a cloud-native microservices-based architecture, and as such, it's modular with the aim to fit into different OSS environments at our customers.
So, Patrik, how can a potential developer interact with the platform to develop new RApps?
So an SDK will be offered together with the Intelligent Automation Platform, and it will enable application developers then to quickly leverage on the platform services that are available in order to build and deploy applications. The SDK will provide capabilities such as helper libraries, debugging capabilities, documentation of APIs, example use cases. It will provide a basic Hello World application that will bring the user through the full process of development and deployment of an application. There will be best practices, documentation, build utilities, and a sandbox to bring on board the application and validate that it will run and so on. In addition to the SDK, Ericsson provides its strong services capabilities, if so required, to support our customers, CSPs, partners, and other application developers with design, deployment, testing, and onboarding, and taking applications into the production system and making use of the value they bring.
And David, can you provide some more details on the RApps that Ericsson is launching today?
We are launching a number of RApps right now that will be increased in the coming months. And we are covering a wide spectrum of RAN automation use cases. For instance, in the area of network deployment, we have a centralized SON, self-organizing network application, with 5G centralized network relations for automatic reconfiguration of the network based on data from user equipment. On the area of network optimization, we have as well Frequency Layer Manager, which is for improving user experience dynamically or a complete performance agnostic startup that leverages on AI and machine learning to analyze more than 150 KPIs per cell proactively for the complete network in minutes, identifying the issues and automatically providing root cause analysis. This number of startups will be increasing in the coming months in different areas of not only deployment and optimization, but network evolution and network healing as well.
Okay, well, it's been great to find out about the Ericsson Intelligent Automation Platform today. Patrik, David, thanks very much for joining us.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.